Hi Hazel, I'm Jessica, and I'm gonna show you your how-to video. I'm so excited for you to get your makeup and your brushes. You seriously hit the jackpot with these. They are incredible. So I'm gonna try my best to not confuse you, but to teach you how to use all of the brushes. I'll probably send you a second video explaining all the brushes. You can use, let's see, any of these four for your entire face, but it's more fun to use them all because they all have the things that they're extra good at. Okay, so let's get into it. You have Sandy, Aura, Astoria, and Pink Grapefruit. I'm gonna start with the detail, okay? The detail, mine is embarrassingly dirty. I don't know why it's so dirty. Okay, we're just gonna use it. So I'm gonna start with the detail. It's got this long side that I just fluffed out. So it's got this longer side, and then it's got this pointier side. And yours is gonna be a little bit different color because mine is old. Mine's the old style. We're gonna start into Astoria. So I think you've probably seen mine where I do the three and the E. I'm gonna break that down for you. So you're gonna swipe the edge of your brush. It doesn't matter what brush you're using. If you're using the Buffy, the buff, you're gonna swipe the edge. If you're using the 3D, you're gonna use the pointed side so that you get a nice little side. If you're using this guy, you can use either side. That's gonna be nice and smudged, and this is going to be smaller. Okay, detail, swipe the edge through. So it's just on the edge, and we're gonna go from the top of our ear towards the bottom of our nose, okay? So that highest point of your cheekbone, you're just below it. So we're not, I can't do it. We're not going into that line that we naturally have because naturally our face is drooping. It's just reality. And so we don't want to go in that line. We want to pick it up to where it used to be. So we're going to go from the top of our ear to the bottom of our nose, and you can just swipe. You can leave it and do all of your blending later, or you can blend it now. Okay, so look what that does. It just like creates this big high cheekbone there. Next side, top of the ear, bottom of the nose. And you will get better at this. Believe me, no one starts perfect, but it only takes a few applications and you start to feel good, like with the brushes and stuff, but it takes time. Okay, so there's the two cheekbones. Let's do the forehead. Now we're gonna brush the whole brush through. I like to go from my part to the top of my ear just because of the shape of face that I have. If you, I would say play around with it because some people like to go straight across. Some people like to do like a triangle. Because I have an oval face, and I have these widow's peaks, that's where I'm gonna go. So I'm just pulling it back to my hairline now. So this stuff moves like butter until it sets in. So if you put your makeup on, wait 15 minutes and then touch your face, and it's gonna feel like your skin. It's so crazy. It feels amazing, and it feels even better when you take it off because it's moisturized your skin all day. Let's tap into it just lightly. We're gonna go down from the ear, and if you happen to have jowls here, you're gonna go right on top of them, and you're just gonna say, "Hey, you're not there," and make it look like they're not there, stopping at your mouth. If you don't have jowls, go down from your ear and go underneath your chin because we still want to define your face. I wish I would have told Jackie about a party before you ordered because she could have got a ton of free makeup, but I think she's going to have a party in the future anyway. So, I mean, I think you have everything you need, but you can keep that in mind that next time you'll be able to help your friend out. Okay, next. You could stick with this side of the brush. I do all the time. Or this, I would pick the pointed side still of the 3D with the blush end. This is the blush end. I would still pick the pointed side for the rest of what I'm gonna do. And then the smudge, no, the blend brush, you can use either side. I'm so sorry if this is confusing. I just want you to love all your brushes and know how to use them. Let's stick with this guy. We're gonna use the fat side, and we're gonna go into your main color, Sandy. Okay, so you have these two colors, Sandy and Aura. One is a little bit lighter than the other. You want to go with the darker one. That's your skin color. Swipe through it, and now we're gonna go down the nose and over each eyebrow. Bring it all the way down the nose. Depending on how much coverage you want, you may want to dip in again, or you might just want to keep dragging it. Okay, so this area is an area, and this area is where we get deep, large pores. If you find your pores are more noticeable, it's because you need to fill them. You need to swipe back and forth about three times, and they will be gone. Okay, so we're gonna go all the way down our nose. We're gonna go on our eyes. And this is gonna set your eyeshadow as well. Oh my gosh, I'm making this video so long. I'm so sorry. Okay, now that there's almost nothing on my brush, you can just go and blend those two together. Done. We're moving on to the lower part of our face. So grab Sandy, go under the contour here. And it's cream. So if you mix it together, it is not a big deal. Under your lip and over your lip. And that's it. That's all you want to do with Sandy. I haven't done this area yet, and I haven't done my blush area. So now I'm going to change brushes. I'm going to use the 3D because if you have it, I love this side for the blush. It's just effortless. And I'm going to choose one of your brighter ones. So Dahlia and Pink Grapefruit. They're going to be the most natural pinks on your cheeks, but they're a little bit bright on the lips. So I'm just going to show you how to work with that. So Pink Grapefruit right here, you're just going to dab. It's quite bright, so you want to blend that baby out. We're going to put it right on top of the contour. I like to stay far away from my nose and far away from my eye. I'm just going to dab. I'm just following. And then if you have extra, you can even just brush it onto your lips. Okay. Wipe off any excess, and now we're going to blend. So all we're going to do is go over it. You can brush it back, you can brush it down, and you can brush it up. And you're just going to blend it until you like it. So you can brush it, you can swirl it, you choose until you like the color. The more you brush, the more it's going to blend in, and then the more natural of a color you get. Okay, so you could use this pointed side now. But you have it, so I would use this tiny side of the detail or the tiny side of the blend brush. And now we're going to go into Aura. Okay, Aura is your brightener. You're going to grab a little bit of Aura and we're going to throw that under your eye. And whatever's left, just do a nice skinny line down your nose. And that contours your nose without really contouring your nose, without going to any extra effort. Okay, now we're going to drag this down our nose and under our eye. And once we've done that, we're just going to fan the rest out. And it just, like that step, just lifts your face. Under the eye, down the nose, fan it out. Okay. I think that's all for your face. Oh, okay, Pink Grapefruit, I was going to show you. So on your lips. It can be, it's really pretty, but it can be a little bit cotton candy, bubblegummy. And so how you change that, take any one of these colors, your contour, your brightening, or your mane, and put it on your lip. Or, oh my gosh, I totally forgot you have like four other lip and cheeks. You can mix all of the lip and cheeks. So plum would be beautiful with this. You can mix them and you're going to get a beautiful color. I'm just going to take my contour though. And it actually almost turns it into plum. So now you get a nicer color that's not so bright and in your face. Before I let you go, it's unfortunate you did not get the eyeshadow brush in that bundle. They change the bundle all the time. So I'm just going to show you Mama in Oak. My children are singing. Mama is gorgeous and Oak is gorgeous. This is Mama. You're just going to grab it with a fluffy end, circle it on the edge, and bring it in. So this is a really, really pretty color that is just going to be very subtle. It's my base for a lot of things, so I'll add colors on top of this. But it's really pretty alone as well. And then you got my absolute favorite color in the whole wide world, and that is Oak. So here we have Oak, fluffy side, same thing, circle it, bring it in. Make sure when you open your eye, you can see it. So I usually finish with my eye open because I am getting hooded eyes. But Oak is just, it's a nice cool brown and it's so pretty. You can also put your contour on your eye or your lip and cheek on your eye. And then I just like to finish it up underneath. So totally different looks, but they're both so pretty. Lastly, You're going to go into your contour with your line brush. So the line brush has the spoolie and the little straight line. You're going to dab your contour and you're just going to strike up. I actually just go from up here and I just strike up and I make these hairline strokes. And like it just, it looks perfect. This line, this brush is just incredible. It's so rigid. And it just makes the perfect, like if you were to look up close, you would never know that I have contour. So you can contour your eyelids. You can even use that line brush to make eyeliner out of your contour. It's endless. Please tell me if you have any questions, if you want to have a party of your own, or if things aren't working out, or if it looks streaky. I can fix all of that for you. Just reach out to me, and I'm so excited. I'm so excited for you to have your new makeup.